Hello guys, welcome back. Today is 93rd day of our 100 days of challenge of Adobe, and from today we are getting in movie VFX effects. So today we are going to create this. So let's get started. So here we are in After Effects. You can see our final composition render 100% wrap code particular. So let's get started. Firstly, make a new composition, name it as main, make the duration 7 seconds, frame rate 30, 1920 by 1080, hit OK. Now create a new solid, name it as core, make it black, composition size sorry, and hit OK. Now select the ellipse tool, hold click in the center, hold control and shift and make a circle like this. Now select the path, press control C to copy it, minimize here. Now search for particular, it is a third party plugin. Apply it here. Before doing anything, let's just hold Alt and click on position XY. Here select position XY and press Ctrl V. Now you can see our particles are animated on the path. So what we can do, select the last point and drag it up to seconds like 18 or 19 frames, up to take it to 18 frame, leave it there, collapse the properties. Now let's change the values here. Before doing that, we can do one thing. As you can see, we need a loop, so type here loop out bracket open and close. We have used the same expression in previous videos also. Now you can see it's looping animation all over the composition. Okay, now let's change the value. Let's change emitter type to sphere. Emitter type to sphere, make the direction to directional and set the direction spread to 5. X rotation, let's make it minus 90. And Y rotation, let's make it minus 90 and minus 1, like this. Now let's animate this also. Hold Alt and click on Y rotation, and at first frame make the minus 1 to 0. Sorry, we need to alter it. Press U. Okay, let's uncheck by again clicking Alt. Now add keyframe on Y and same on 18th frame, make the minus 1 to 0. Okay, now again Alt click on Y rotation and type loop out open and close bracket, the same expression. Yeah, perfect. Now let's change the velocity to 0. Velocity to 0. The velocity random to 100. And the velocity distribution to 0. Velocity from motion to 15. Emitter size X 0. Emitter size Y 0. And emitter size Z, let's make it 150, like this. Now come to particle, make the life 0.3, the life random, let's keep it as it is. Let's make the sphere feather to 0. Let's make the size 3. Let's make the size random to 50. and let's open the size over life and select pen tool, just delete these center. Okay, sorry, size over life, select this point, press delete, this point delete, and drag this point at center and this one at the end. Create a curve map like this. Now you can see we have a curve like this. So the next step is add keyframes on. Come to frame number 20 like this. Add keyframe on particle per second. Then velocity from motion and life. These three keyframes. Then select your layer, press U to open all the keyframes. After two or three frames, let's just before here on these keyframes, let's make the particle 15,000 like this, and some 2-3 keyframes ahead, go 2-3 frames ahead, make the particles 30,000. Let's make the velocity from motion to 35 and the life to 0.4. Okay, now you can see we have a little bit jerk animation here between. So let's do one thing again. Let's, as you can see, we are here to 26. Go 20 frames ahead like this here and select all of these three keyframes. Press Ctrl C, Ctrl V. So now you can see we have a little bit jerk animation in between here. Here's the preview. You can see we have a little bit jerk animation like this. So let's come down here, come to physics. Let's make the in physics, let's make gravity to 500 and let's make the ear to bounce, and in bounce let's change the collision event to kill. Now let's create a floor first. Create a new solid, name it as floor, and let's make it white. Okay, let's make the layer 3D. Press W, hold shift and drag it, click on X and drag it here to snap it on 90 degrees, or we can just make it -90. Now press V to get your selection tool and drag this layer down on Z axis. Now let's just select the core again, come to physics and select the floor layer to floor. Now your particles are going to kill after they bounce on the floor. Let's off the floor visibility, we don't need it. Okay, now let's just collapse the properties. Select the core layer, press Ctrl T to duplicate it. Select both of the layers, press U to open the properties. Now drag this top one layer just few frames ahead to get opposite like this. Now select all of these keyframes, drag them in one side like this, and select now these keyframes and drag them little bit more forward like this. Again press U to collapse all the properties. Now you can see we have these two different animation cycles. So the next method is to create our core is done, the basic core. The next method is to create outer structure. So select the below core layer, press Ctrl T to duplicate it, drag it on the top, right click, rename, and rename it as core 2. This is the second core. Now open, let's uncheck the particle keyframes and make the keyframe 750. Let's make the velocity to 300, velocity distribution, let's make it to 5, random as it is, velocity distribution to 5, and velocity from motion, uncheck the keyframe and let's make it 20. Now let's come to particle, uncheck the life and make the life 0.2, and the size let's make 0, because we don't need the main particles, we need the auxiliary particles. So let's come to physics tab. In physics, make the physics model to air, and let's make the gravity to 1000. Okay, and let's come down in air properties and select the turbulence field, and in turbulence field change the effect position to 250 to get a little bit turbulent. Now open your auxiliary system, make it continuously, and then change the particle per second to 350. Let's make the life to 0.2, the size to 3, and let's change the size over life, the map something like, let's take the point tool, drag the end point here, the second point here, the third one little bit here, the fourth one little bit more down, and we can just delete this last point. So we have a nice fade out. You can see we have a nice fade out effect on your size. Then let's come to opacity over life. Open opacity over life. Let's select the pen tool, drag the end point here, the middle point here, the third point here. And we can do one thing, let's add another point like this. Okay, done for opacity over life. Let's make the opacity to 100, color from main 100%, and we are done for here. Okay, one remaining, let's add, make the blending mode to add. Okay, we are done with our outer particles. Let's just minimize it, select the core to duplicate it. You can see we have two cores like this. Okay, looking fine. Yep, perfect. So let's select the core to core layer. Yep, next the outer particles. Select the main core, duplicate it, drag it. Okay, drag it on the top, and let's rename it as outer particles. Let's keep it outer. Click on the particle, uncheck the particle keyframe, and let's make the particles per second to 20,000. A little bit more. Okay, then let's make the velocity a great value like 5,600. Like this. Let's make the velocity distribution to 5 again. Then let's come to life. We can change the velocity from motion, and check the keyframe, and let's make it 20. Let's come to life in particle, and check the life, and make the life to 0.7. For greater particles, let's just in size over life, let's just check this one. Okay, and let's just take the pen tool, let's just delete the center points, delete this one, delete same, delete, we don't need too much points here. Okay, we are also going to delete this one, drag this point up to here, this point up to here, and this point here. A nice fade out animation like this at the start. Now we are done for this one also. So what we have to do next, let's just collapse this property, select the outer, control D, and drag it same as here. So now we have two layers like this animating. So what we have to do next, we need to bounce some particles from the floor. So select the outer, duplicate it, drag it on the top, rename it as bounce. Okay, select the bounce, let's make the X rotation little bit more lower, -190. Let's press U to open its keyframes, come on the last keyframe of Y rotation, and let's make the Y rotation to 0 and delete this loop out expression and type new expression wiggle open bracket 5, 200. So in each 5 frames it is going to wiggle in 200 points, a little bit more great values. So the next we have to change the velocity, let's make it lower, let's make it 3000. Then for the velocity random, let's keep it as it is. Same for velocity distribution, let's change the emitter size Z, let's make it 1000, a little bit more greater in Z depth. Now come to size over life, because we are not going to change any of the middle values. Let's come to size over life, we can just choose this one. Again come to pen tool, select this point, delete, it happens every time. Delete this point, this point, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one. Now drag you at this point up to here, this one point up to here, and you can delete the last point like this. Yeah, this seems perfect. Now come to physics, the main thing is going to happen in physics. Let's change the gravity little bit more greater, 1500, and let's just change the collision event to bounce and select the bounce value to 14, little bit lower, and let's make this slide to 35. And as you can see, we have done for the portal like this, some particles are bouncing, we have a nice go animation. Same for the other, we can do one thing, let's just drag this bounce some keyframes ahead. Okay, let's we have a scene, yeah, looking fine. So let's just make the these particles little bit more brighter. Go to color correction, curves, select the channel to alpha and drag this to up like this. Select the curves, press Ctrl C. Okay, drag this up to here. Okay, yep. Alpha, drag this up, select the curves, press Ctrl C. It's not copying rightly because it's alpha, it's not having any values, I don't know why. You can just apply it on bounce first. Curves, alpha channel, make it brighter, select the curves, edit, copy, outer one, edit, paste, same for the outer, another, paste. Now you can see we have these bright particles. Let's check the motion blur for all of these particles. You can on the motion blur of the composition from here. Now you can see we have some natural animation here going. Okay, you can see this core 2 and core particles are looking little bit greater, nice. Let's add color correction. You can just right click, new adjustment layer, right click, video copilot, CC color vibrance. It's 100% free plugin, you can download it from video copilot. Let's choose the color to little bit orange looking color like this. Perfect. Right click, stylize, glow. Let's make the threshold to 100%, radius to 100%. Oh, let's make radius too much greater, 500, and let's make the intensity to 2. Yep. This is the soft glow. Select the glow, press Ctrl D to duplicate it. Let's reduce the radius to 100 and decrease the intensity to 1. Now you can see we have this hard glow only on the particles. So that's the portal. I have just added my logo behind. So guys, that's it for today. Hope you have learned to create this Doctor Strange portal effect. I haven't added the live action footages behind, so not necessary, because you can just render it in overlay and add it in your videos. So don't forget to like the video. If you are new here, be sure to subscribe the channel. So let's meet tomorrow again. Till then, stay safe, take care, and keep watching the channel.